Heated debates seem to rule the day. We live in a divided nation that's becoming even more polarized. Over the years, we've seen North versus South, Republican versus Democrat, conservative versus liberal, the left versus the right, rich versus poor, white versus black and brown. This country, though, was founded on philosophical and ideological differences, but we always find a way to pull together. Today, it often feels that we're pulled so far to the extremes that there's almost no one left in the middle. And it seems like there's even less willingness to find reasonable compromises. Our differences threaten to strip us of shared values, shared goals, and more importantly, shared dreams. There are people today who no longer believe in the American dream. Some think it's a nightmare. Others believe it's a thing of the past. While I don't agree with that, and I do recognize that someone who can feel lost in the process or denied opportunity could hold some of these sentiments. But you know, populism is more than political jargon, and it's growing in many parts of the world, including this great country of ours. It's a force that can break up families. It can keep people from earning a living. It can send entire communities into hiding. Some families are even transferring custody of their children to friends or family members in case the parents are deported. Suddenly, there are more empty seats in classrooms, fewer day laborers looking for work, and some businesses have seen sharp drop-offs in business. Now, I know to this crowd I am preaching to the choir, but it's still something that needs to be said. This is not the America that many of us, thank you. This is not the America that many of us have dreamed of. It's one that looks just a little too much like what I saw growing up in the Deep South in the 1960s, when back in the 60s, when the nation seemed ready to split apart at the seams. Now, in 1974, I was an 18-year-old student at Delta State when I did take the part-time job at UPS that Janet talked about. Now, I know 1974, many of you were not even alive in 1974, but back then as well as now, you can learn a lot sorting packages and loading trailers in the middle of the night, especially when you're doing it with coworkers. The most important thing I learned is that when you are loading these packages and you are working side by side, it does not matter if the person is black, white, or brown. It does not matter if they go to a church, a synagogue, or a mosque, or even if they go to any, or if they're religious at all. It doesn't matter if they're conservative or if they're liberal. What matters is that you work together to get the job done. So when you work side by side with someone, you quickly learn that we're a lot more alike than we are different. So I tell people, while I got my degree at Delta State, I actually feel like I received my honorary master's in diversity and inclusion from UPS. Because UPS was the first really integrated environment I had ever been around at the time. That seems strange now, but then that was absolutely the case. And so it really taught me a completely different view on life. And if there was ever a time when we need to put aside differences to do our jobs, no matter what our jobs are, it is absolutely now. I say that because I still believe in the American dream. You know, I am a child of the Mississippi Delta. I was the first in my family to graduate from college. And through hard work, but also the help of many, many UPSers along the way, I now have the opportunity to lead a great company like UPS. And I am thankful each and every day for that opportunity. I'm also proud to see NCLR and UPS making that dream possible for others. UPS has partnered with NCLR over 35 years, focusing our people and our funding on programs that give the Latino community greater opportunity. For 12 years, Janet Morgia has been a fearless leader through difficult challenges, advocating tirelessly on behalf of all underserved and underrepresented communities. I have had a chance to talk to her on several occasions, and I've just been so impressed by the passion and enthusiasm that she has to make a difference. And so we are really overjoyed to work with this organization, and our work together comes down to three shared beliefs. And I believe that most everyone in this room has these three beliefs. First, everyone has a dream and a story. And each person's story is both unique, but is part of the full story. And that's the point of diversity. Eduardo Martinez and his family came to this country with few resources. They learned a new language, worked hard, and raised Ed and his sister to focus on education, family, and community. Ed joined UPS in 1976, so he's still a little bit junior, right? He joined again, as I did, as a package handler. And like so many of the people in our company, his hard work and talent was recognized. For years, Ed worked as an attorney in our legal department. In 2012, he was appointed president of the UPS Foundation. And 3 years later, he was also named Chief Diversity and Inclusion Officer and is an important member of our leadership team. And at UPS, if you're the Chief Diversity and Inclusion Officer, that is a big deal. It gives you a pulpit that you can speak, but it also gives Ed a chance to make sure that everybody in the company are also diversity and inclusion officers, right? Because it's not one person's responsibility. But Ed had a dream, and he has seen it come true. And he earned it, obviously, too. And now he's committed to helping other UPSers, that's what we call employees of UPS, and other people in the community to also realize those dreams. So our second shared belief: everyone deserves to be heard. Diversity without inclusion is a numbers game. And I want to say that again. Diversity without inclusion is a numbers game. Inclusion ensures people are heard. Business understands that as good as anyone. At UPS, we know that we're a stronger, more successful business because of the melting pot of voices, opinions, experiences, and cultures that contribute to our goals. One great example of that is Juan Perez. Juan immigrated with his family to the U.S. at the age of 18. Today, he's the chief information officer and chief engineering officer of UPS. In his 27 years at UPS, Juan has been the driving force behind a number of incredible innovations that are improving the way that UPS does business. He's still coming up with new ideas, and I'm confident that he will deliver those new ideas for many, many years to come. I'm looking at him now, so I just made a commitment for him. But he'll tell you that with all these innovations, that he's proudest of his work with UPS, with UPS's Hispanic Latino Business Resource Group, which among other things has played a key role in rolling out several Spanish level language versions of UPS products and services. At UPS, we view diversity and inclusion as the right thing for our culture, our people, and our customers, and it is the smart thing for our business. It's a core value for UPS, one we are proud of and committed to uphold in spite of what may or may not be happening in the rest of the world. This is so important to us. The third belief that we share is that everyone deserves a chance. Several years ago, we began helping NCLR expand its impact on Latino youth through several key programs. Now UPS is honored to be the primary funder of the Escalada program, and we're inspired by the stories coming out of this program, like the story of 18-year-old Jennifer Salamanca. Jennifer lives with her father, who had to leave school after first grade. And as much as he encouraged her, he couldn't help her navigate the college admissions process. Escalada did, though. And today, she's a freshman at Middle Tennessee State University, with a whole world of opportunity ahead of her. In addition to Jennifer, this program has helped many students and will continue to reach many others. Programs like this is why we value our partnership with NCLR, because it makes a difference. So diversity, inclusion, opportunity. The shared beliefs our two organizations are also, the shared belief of our two organizations are also the foundation of the American dream. In my opinion, that business and its leaders, as well as government and civic organizations, must continue to build on this foundation. It's what's made our country the land of opportunity, and in spite of all of its challenges, we are still the land of opportunity. We also must challenge any threat to the soundness of those beliefs, because we cannot reap the benefits of a diverse workforce without doing everything in our power to ensure that all people have the opportunity to reach their potential. So in addition to my other responsibilities, I'm chair of the Diversity Inclusion Steering Council at UPS. I'm determined that we do not lose sight of the importance of diversity and inclusion to our people and to our business. And I understand the tone is set at the top and that I have to lead the example. Like NCLR, we continue to focus on creating a more inclusive culture, one that values diversity in all its forms. But I think we would all acknowledge that we have more work to do. For every Juan Perez, Ed Martinez, and Jennifer Salamanca, opportunity has been the path to a brighter future. But for many others, the path may not seem so straight. And that begs a very important question. Can we make things better? I stand here today confident that working together, we can. To make certain, we must ensure the American dream is attainable for all who are willing to reach for it. We must decide that opportunity is an unquestionable right worthy of our best efforts. So everyone sees the value in the differences that make us as a nation unlike any other, a mosaic that isn't complete without every single colorful tile. We will accomplish these things through partnerships like the one we have with NCLR. In her speech at this event last year, Janet said, "Some people like to say that America has lost its way, that its greatness is a thing of the past. But the American dream has never been more alive." And I want to repeat what she said that last sentence. The American dream has never been more alive. She went on to say, "We have the power to decide who we are as a country and what we stand for. Our destiny is in our hands." That is the true definition of the American dream. That is the America we must all work to uphold. For inspiration, we will continue to look to the National Council of La Raza and to the women and men of the affiliates and companies that help make their work possible. Thank you.